visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I think recording note. Okay, fine. So let's proceed. I think we have finished module number one. We'll go ahead with your module number two. So I'll just brief out things. What is you're going to learn in module number two? So still you are joining. Okay. Let's go ahead. Is this paint visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Yeah, we'll be discussing with respect to your module two today. So we have completed your module one. So that's the lengthiest chapter among all the five modules what we have. So now we'll move on with your syllabus. So don't worry, your syllabus will be quicker from now onwards because the time consumption required here is less. So module number two involves two separate categories here. So you'll be dealing with the two subtopics. So out of 40 marks, you can expect one full question from your system concept. So in module number two, you're learning a concept based on systems. And second part will be on LTI system. I hope you enter this word LTI in your control system. If you know. Is it correct? Linear time invariant system. With respect to your signal flow graph. If signal flow graph topic has started, so then the LTI concept will come there, right? Okay. So as you learned in module number one, my voice is clear, right, to everyone? Okay. So module number one, you completely discussed about signals. So module number two, one part will be discussing only about the systems. Okay, so how you learn to signals, same repeats here. So CT as well as DT. So instead of telling CT and DT signals, so now we should talk it as CT and DT systems. So both will be naming with the same thing. So if I say CTS, it can be what? Continuous time signal also system. And continuous time system also. So whenever they tell these two words, so be careful. So the question will be clearly mentioned whether we want to explain about system or signals. So we just make a clear statement and go ahead. Okay. So that is one of we are going to learn. So properties are there. Six properties in systems will fetch you 20 marks, guys. So 20 marks you can expect from this system topic as a one full question from module number two. And one more topic in that same module number two is LTI system, which will fetch you 24 marks. So now we'll try to concentrate only on your first part of your module two, that is your systems. Okay. So can anyone state me what is the meaning of a system? So we have discussed already signals means what, system means what. Can anyone tell me what is the meaning of a system? Yes. Can anyone tell me what is the meaning of a system? Exactly, you learned in your signals. You are passing your signals to what? You have input signal with you, we have output signal with you. So what is the usefulness of system? Where you found actually the system concept? You're thinking the answer or you waiting for someone to tell Is it visible what I'm writing?
Yes, sir.
So this was your input. And similarly, we had output. So between input to output, there was a bridge or a barrier that it was, we are going to call it a system. Okay. So we already got, if we deal with respect to your CT type of system, then the input should be x of t. So it means input should be continuous time. So then output will be y of t. So I need to pass this input to any system. So depending upon the application, you can choose what system you want. If it is analog, analog system. If it is digital, digital system. Okay. So this system is going to produce you a response. I hope you remember the things what we learned in module number one, and just recollecting it, right? So what exactly your y of t is equal to now? It is a product of your input signal to your response of system. So we can write y of t is equals to x of t into h of t. This is what you learned in module number one. Yes or no, yeah? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So what exactly I asked is, what is the way to define your system? Okay. So we'll define system now. So system is a set of elements. So in this system, you can consisting of any elements or any functional blocks, right? That are connected together. For what we should connect it together? To produce an output in combination with my input signal, correct? So output is this y of t. To get output, I need to pass my input x of t, and corresponding response we are going to get as h of t. So combination of these two itself is what system does. Is it clear? I'll repeat a statement. If they ask you to define a system, you can state like this: it is a set of elements or functional blocks that are connected together and produce an output in response to an input signal. Okay, so combination of input and the response h of t will fetch you a system concept. Okay, so definition, is it okay to everyone? Definition, is it okay?
Yes, sir.
I'm audible. Okay, fine. So once you know definition, then comes classification, like how we went through with your signals. So your classifications was mainly based on two categories. Can you tell me which are the two categories here? Classifications. So the two major categories what we had here. What is this naming?
Continuous, yes, and discrete, sir.
Good. So first one is called CT. Now I am not adding the word signal. This is system. So that is why I told, don't get confused with system and signal, because anyhow you will be having separate models questions. So clearly mentioned, you have given signal means what, system means what. So you just have a mindset, because both words look similar only. CTS, DTS. So classification, continuous time, system. Discrete time system. So if you go with respect to my CT system, that is my this CTS system. So what could be my input, guys? It should be a what? X of t. What is the meaning of x of t? Nothing but continuous time
signal.
Good. So whenever we choose, see, I am representing a different way here and here. If this is CTS inside, this is called system. If I provide CT signal, that means input level. So I am going to get output also in terms of what? CT only. Yes or no? How we are going to give the input, same we are going to get output. Yes or no? Only thing we need to analyze with help of system. So whenever I choose analog, CT means nothing but analog signal, right? So whenever I choose any analog signal to any system, then what are all the different real-time examples we can consider for this? If I give analog input to a system, so what type of system can be used? We can use different types of systems, like analog filters. We can use amplifiers. We can use attenuators. We can use analog transmitters, analog receivers. So these are the few examples what we can consider for CT system. I repeat, if you be dealing with respect to your CT system, input will be CT signal. So for that, corresponding examples will be with respect to analog filters, attenuators, or analog transmitter, or amplifier, or receiver. So wherever the word analog comes, there comes your system concept. Am I clear till you? Is it okay, guys? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So now, similarly, we can consider one more system which talks with respect to my DT. So DT. So what is the input now? What's the naming I should change from the previous to this? Instead of x of t, what we should write?
Input should be x of n and output should be y of n, sir.
Good. So input become x of n because with respect to discrete, nothing but digital. So here also you'll be having response called as h of n. Okay. So this is your DT system. So whenever I pass my discrete times to your system is having DT. So what are the possible examples you can consider here? So you can consider examples like computers, printers, or processors, or any memories, or shift registers. These all act like a digital. I hope you all learned this, right? So you know what is the meaning of printer? You know what is the meaning of a shift registers? So there is a controller, there is a processor, so there can be a memory. So whichever element involves with this type of example, we are going to call it as discrete time. Am I clear with this 2 points to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Is it okay till here? Okay. So what we started module number 2. I told clearly out of 40 marks from module number 2, 20 marks you are going to get purely from your systems and 20 marks purely from your LTA system. So we are discussing first part of module 2, that is called as your systems. We discuss system definition for 2 marks. Then we went through with the classification. We told CTS means what, DTS means what. Then we took examples of CTS and DTS and we written a block diagram. So if they ask you to explain, define and write the classification, so this much answer should be given, so it carries 5 marks. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. So we will move on to the next major part. So once we did the classifications of signal, we are categorized into 4 different parts. So odd, even, periodic, non-periodic, energy, power, deterministic and random. So there the complete topic was on classification, but here the complete topic will be on properties. So you're not going to deal any concept based on any classification. Classification we already know. So we just need to know what is the properties involved in this. Okay. So we'll list the properties first. So this property, as I told, will fetch you how much marks? 20 marks. So in this, there are some properties which involves derivations and problems. So we can expect derivations and problems from that topic only, and remaining are like problems. So we will do all the 6 properties one by one, and we'll try to analyze what is the difference we can find in each property. So if we go and list the property, so properties are broadly divided into 6 categories. So properties are broadly divided into 6 types. So is it visible what I'm writing, everyone? What I'm writing, is it visible? Is it audible or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we are discussing properties. I told properties are broadly divided into categories here. So let's try to list one by one. Then we will go in detail. So dynamicity property is first one. What we have? Then you have shift invariance. So you will come to know some words which you already used in your control system. So like LTA system, do you remember? So that we are going to discuss with respect to the second property called shift invariance. And third property mainly deals with the linearity. So linearity property is your category number 3. So there are subtypes that we will discuss one by one. So let me list the things first. Then there is a property called causality. So we're going to tell some set of systems are called as causal. Okay. Causality. So then property number 5 will be dealing with respect to your stability property. Stability. You just make a note, everyone. So what all things we'll discuss? This property will fetch you 20 marks. Stability. And last one, 6th one, is called as invertibility. Invertibility, nothing but it's a reciprocal property. We'll discuss later. So what about all 6 properties to everyone? Is it okay, guys?
Yes.
Yeah. So just a second. So whenever they ask you to list the properties of a system, so you can list the 6 properties. So then we'll go one by one, guys. So we'll go with the first one called dynamic or dynamicity property. So whenever the list comes, so whatever list I have made, so there are 2 subdivisions will take place in this. So if I say dynamicity, you'll be having 2 subcategory. So one is called static, one more is called as dynamic. I'll repeat in terms of properties. First one, dynamicity. So dynamicity has been further divided into 2 subcategory called as static systems and dynamic system. So you need to know what type of signals are called as static system and what type of signals are called as dynamic system. Okay, that is one category. Similarly, your shift, invariance, or broadly divided into 2 category. One is called time variant and one more is called time invariant. Time variant and time invariant. Okay. So property number 3, linearity. So linearity, you can tell a signal is called linear or non-linear. So under linearity, you will have 2 categories called as linear or non-linear system. So again, if you go with respect to causality, you can tell the system is called causal or non-causal. So I'm just writing abbreviation. If you have doubt, you can ask. Stability, you can tell again 2 words in this. One is called stable and one more is called unstable. You should not use the word non-stable, so it is called unstable. Stable, unstable. Okay. So last category, invertibility. So here, this is having 2 more category called as inversible and non-inversible. Inversible and non-inversible. So except the last property number 6, remaining 5 properties, there are derivations come problems. So we will discuss that one by one. So out of 20 marks, you can expect explanation of any of these properties for 10 marks along with the derivation. And one more 10 marks maybe for the problem. So this is how the marks split up will happen in this module number 2, first part. Am I clear till here to everyone? Okay, fine. So can anyone summarize the 6 properties, the heading what I have written, so that I will come to know what you understood till now. Then we will go one by one. Yes. Anyone summarize the 6 property what we listed with the shortcuts, the naming what I have done, then I can go further. Yeah.
The 6 properties are dynamicity property, shift invariance, linearity property, causality property, stability property, invertibility property.
Good.
And we come across static and dynamic systems in dynamicity property, time Good. Invariant and time variant systems in shift invariance property.
Good.
Linear and non-linear systems in linearity property.
Yes.
Causal and non-causal systems in causality property. Stable yes. and unstable systems in stability property. Inversible yes. and non-inversible systems in invertibility property.
Very good. So these are the list what we can make. So now we will go one by one. Okay. So once I deal with one by one property, there are few property which involves derivations, come problems, and few only problems. So then, if you go with respect to problem oriented from this system, they will give one question x of t or x of n. With that one signal, they will ask you to find all the six property. That will fetch you 10 more marks. Okay. So now we are discussing the first part of system, that is your 10 marks for properties, individual explanation. So once it comes to a problem in a group, one problem will be given so that you can answer all the system's property with a single problem only. Okay. So that type we will discuss once you finish individual property. So let's move on to the first property called as dynamic property. So as the name tells, dynamic, dynamicity. So we have two categories in this. So as I said, you need to discuss with respect to static and dynamic. See, in general, you understand what is the meaning of static. Then we will go with a statement, how to define or how to state. Okay. So whenever I say static, what is the meaning of the word static in general? Static means what? Yes, guys. What is the meaning of the word static? What is the meaning of static? You not heard the word static? Yeah, I'm waiting for your answers. Have you heard static dynamic concept or not?
No movement.
No movement, good. So in general, I can call constant, that is called static. No movement is called static, very good. So which is having movement is called dynamic, good. So now this is a generalized thing. So with respect to our signals system, we will discuss static in terms of memory, okay? So if there is no memory, such type of signals we are going to call it as static systems. So if there is memory, they are called as dynamic. Am I clear with the things what I told to everyone? So whenever you use the word static, it means it is having memoryless element. So there is no memory to store the things, or a memoryless element. Is it okay what I told? No memory is called as static and memory is called as dynamic. So in general, memoryless systems are called as static system, memory system are called as dynamic system. Am I okay with this, what I told to everyone? Proceed, is it okay?
Yes.
So just show the things. Static means no memory or memoryless. Dynamic means memory. Okay. So this is what a general meaning to remember the things. Why I'm telling is you need to know. See, remembering all six property once in exam, it will become like messed up. Which one is which property is which. So that time you just remember the keyword what I told you. So once the memory comes with respect to your memory, dynamic. No memory, static. That's it. So this keyword will help you to remember all the six properties. So each has the same keywords we will discuss later. Now, if you move on to static, so we need to know or we need to analyze one example, right? So that I can tell this system belongs to a memoryless element. So before that, we'll just make a note of a definition. So a CT system is said to be static or memoryless The same thing you can replica for DT also, guys. Whatever things we are discussing with respect to CT, how we went through in signals, no, same concept. X of T replaced with X of N, right? A CT system is said to be static if its output depends upon the present input only. Underline the word that present input only. I'll repeat the statement. A CT system or DT system is said to be static if its output, I hope you can see what I'm writing here, if its output depends upon present input only. So if it is depending only on the present input, so it means it is not having any memory to store. It is just depending on the present input. Such kind of systems we are going to call it as static system. So in this system, you can expect a theory like what I'm telling, definition. So they may ask you to state or list or explain the property. This is a part of a theory for 6 to 8 marks. So remaining marks is on problems only. So don't depend completely on theory. It's just a statement which will fetch you 2 or 3 to 2 marks. Okay. Is it okay till here? Shall I proceed, guys? Everyone? Is it okay, the statement what I told for static?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So we'll go and explain some examples now. So I hope everyone remember Ohm's law. So what is the formula for Ohm's law, guys? What is Ohm's law formula? What is Ohm's law? Ohm's law tells your voltage V is equal to
R. Yes, sir.
Good. So V is equals to I into R is a generalized formula. So if I am varying this with respect to my CT signal, so I can represent this as V of T, correct? Is equals to R is kept constant, so R into I of T. So this is how we represent, guys. Agree with this, everyone? So this is what the general representation we perform whenever we're dealing with respect to my CT signal. Is it okay till here? Yes. So now you tell me how this equation is an example for static. Our output depends upon. Is it audible? Any communication break? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So just kind of move on our hands. Screen is visible, right? Visible, guys. Okay, fine. So now I told the statement and I told your V of T is equal to R into I of T could be example for static. So on what basis we're telling it is static is a question. So what is depending on what? Can you tell me from this example and comparing the statement? Say, want you to analyze. Otherwise, you can't analyze the signals when you solve the problem. Try to analyze the thing what I'm telling. So output is what, input is what? Can you tell me here? V of T is equal to R into I of T from this output, guys.
Sir, I of T is the input, sir. V of T is the voltage drop.
So V of T is output. Yes. So it, I can call V of T is as a output and I of T as an input. Agree? Yes or no? So is this statement matching to your static? Output depends upon the present input. So output is your voltage V of T that is depending upon the present input current I of T only. So can we consider this V is equals to IR as an example for the static? Agree, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, see, understand the meaning. If it is, if the output is depending only on the present input, that is only we are going to call it a static. If it is having instead of present, previous or past, then there will be some memory that we are going to call it as dynamic. This is a simple logic. Okay. So now let me tell one more example. So I want you to analyze and tell me whether this signal belongs to your static or dynamic. Okay. So let me choose. Just one second. Okay, is it audible now? I'm audible, Vesh?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now I'm going to write an example. So you tell me whether it belongs to static or dynamic. Okay. So V of t is equals to 1 by C, integration minus infinity to your t with a current I of t into dt. Okay, is this example belongs to static or dynamic? Yes, guys. So this example, what I wrote?
Dynamic, sir.
Dynamic? On what basis you will tell it is dynamic here?
Sir, because of the presence of the capacitance, we see that there is some property of storing of the charges, so which in turn
supports
the properties of storing the data.
Yes, very good. So I hope everyone remember the capacitor, right? See, capacitor is having a capacity to store and the store as well as charging and discharging of the elements. But with respect to resistor, that capacity is not there. It is only to resist the flow of current, right? So whenever you have a memory with respect to your given system or a signal, so this type of system or a signal, we can clearly mention it as a dynamic. So if we talk with respect to statement wise, so we know that V of t is output, correct? So look at this equation. So V of t across the capacitor depends upon the present as well as next part of your current. Yes or no? Output is depending upon present as well as next part, because you have integration here and you have some memory with respect to capacitor. So is it a brand statement what we can make? Everyone, have you got the concept now how to debug or how to justify yourself? Whatever signals they are given, whether this belongs to CT or DT with respect to memory and dynamic. Is it okay to everyone? Am I clear with this? If you say yes, I can proceed. If you have doubt, you can ask us. Any doubts, anyone?
No, sir.
Okay. So now you got an idea what is the meaning of your dynamic and static with respect to your CT system. So let me give you some data with respect to DT. So I want to answer from you now. So let me choose a signal Y of N that is understood, that is N is there, so it is a DT. So Y of N is equal to some amplitude, let me give the value as 10, into X of N. So is this a category belongs to static or dynamic? See, this is what you are supposed to solve in the problem, guys. There will be given question like this and you need to debug whether the given question is static or dynamic. So we'll do one by one first, then in one problem we will do all the six property, that is the last part of the system. Yes, so by looking at this Y of N 10 times of X of N, this belongs to which category? This belongs to which category? Static, right? See, it is like same, no? So in place of v of t, y of n, in place of r 10, in place of I of t, x of n. So we can easily conclude there is no memory involved in this. We can call it as static. So you hope everyone got an idea now. Is it okay, guys? Shall I give one more example? You will tell what is this now. So if you y of n is equals to 15 x square of n plus some 5 x of n. Yeah. So what this category now? Observe the things carefully and tell me whether it is static or dynamic. So this is a given signal for you with respect to dt is the only change. So 15 x square of n plus 5 x of n. Is it static or dynamic? Is it static or dynamic here? Repeat.
Static, sir.
So why it is called static?
See that the function x of n depends on past and the present function.
Depends upon present there's and past time.
No.
Just no present delay. Only present or present and past?
Yes, sir.
So there is no concept of past or present or past or future. It is having only present value. Whenever it is having x of n with respect to y of n, it is called as present value only. So whether they give x square, x cube, x power 4, whatever it is x of n only, right? So there is no memory involved in this. On that basis, you can judge this is called as a static element. Am I clear? If this x of n is having, as your friend told, advance or delay like n plus 1 or n minus 1, then only there is a memory element. Otherwise, it remains same only. Am I clear? Am I clear?
Yes.
Anybody have doubts? Good. So now let me give you the last example. So I want you to tell this belongs to which category. So y of n is equals to x of n plus x of n minus 1. So this is our dynamic. Is it static or dynamic? Yes. What is the answer? You are thinking answer or you are doing something else and not getting any response, yes? So x of n is equal to, sorry, x of n plus x of n minus 1, is it a part of static or dynamic is a question. What's your answer?
Dynamic, sir.
Why it is dynamic here? See, once you said dynamic, you should justify the answer, no? So answer whatever is dynamic, correct. But on what basis, see, justifying answer, it should be understood to everyone such a way that, oh, this is why it is called dynamic. Yeah? Why it is dynamic, guy? Someone told answer, no?
Sir, n minus 1, no. X.
Yes, good. Tell, continue, correct.
Sir, x of n, n minus 1 is the continuation of x of n, no, sir. So there is memory involved.
So this x minus, n minus 1 is called as a previous or a past?
Past, sir.
N minus 1 means previous. So n plus 1 means past. Okay, now?
Past.
So if you look at this example, x of n, your y of n is depending upon the present x of n as well as previous x of n minus 1. So whenever the statement goes along with present, with previous or past, a system belongs to dynamic. Yes or no? Everyone understood what I told? Is it fine to everyone with the concept? How to justify yourself whether the given system is static or dynamic? Is it okay? Is it okay to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So these are the different examples what you can learn in this first property called as dynamicity. So explain dynamicity means you need to write a statement. Statement tells that you need to know the definition. How will you define the definition? Then the different categories, what is involved in this static and dynamic. Then we will know some examples. So this will tell you, what exactly the meaning of the first property. Is it okay till here? Record is it okay? Everyone till here? Yes. Is it audible? Yeah.
It's fine.
Yeah. Any doubts, anyone, with respect to your? Is it audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So if understood this much, so that completes your property number one. So this is individually we are solving. So analyze the signal properly and decide whether it is given system signal is dynamic or static. Okay. So let's move on to property number two. If anybody have any doubts regarding the first property, you can ask here. So analyzing individual property and analyzing with simple example is what you are supposed to learn in this six properties. Okay. So let's move on to the second one. Second property is called as what? What is the name of second property we went through?
Shift invariance, sir.
So shift invariance. So category we told we have two. So this is property number two, what we're discussing. So under this, we have two separate categories called as time invariant as well as time variant. Okay, so we'll try to understand what is the meaning of time variant and invariant first, then we'll go with a small property derivation is there, then analyze the problem. So this is the steps you are supposed to follow for any property. Okay, so I hope you don't know what is the meaning of a time. You know what is the meaning of time? Yes or no? I think in first chapter you went through with different concepts of your timing. So time shifting, time scaling, time folding. Yes or no? Yeah. Am I correct? Everyone? If you respond, I can go faster. Yes.
Yes, sir.
Good. So now, with respect to these systems, we just need to know what is the meaning of time invariant and variant. Okay. So in simple word, so let me give you an example. If there is a slight change with respect to my input, I'll repeat. If there is a slight change with respect to my input, do we expect the same change with respect to my output also? Yes. There is a slight change with respect to my input. Do we expect the same thing at the output level? Yes. I'm audible here. I have something I want the response. So there is a slight change with respect to my input signal. do we expect same change with respect to my output? Say yes or no. If we say yes, we'll conclude. If we say no, we'll discuss what is the meaning of that in detail, not an issue. Yeah? If there is slight change with respect to my input, do you think it will reflect the output also?
Yes, sir.
Good. So such kind of system is what we are going to call as time invariant system. Time invariant means if there is some delay with respect to my input, same delay I can expect with respect to my output. Simple example. For example, arrival and departure of your train, bus or flight. See, arriving, if it is 10 minutes late, for example, you want to board your bus at 9:30, it came some 10-15 minutes late. Instead of that 10-15 minutes late, we expect it is more to reach the destination also in 10-15 minutes late. We predict or not? Yes or no, yeah? Arrival, departure of your any transportations. If there is some delay with respect to arriving, that is source, do we expect the same thing to reach the destination? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
See, that is what the meaning of time invariant. See, few times, even though the driver came late for 10-15 minutes, because of the speed, he will increase the speed and he may reach the destination as earlier only. That is secondary. But we predict that if bus or train or flight is delayed by this much time, the same we can expect to reach. That mindset is there or not? Such kind of systems we are going to call it as time invariant system. Okay, so now let's compare with the reverse concept of time variant. So time variant means it is like fixed. For example, if I say season, so winter, summer, is it fixed or is it changing? Seasons in a year, is it fixed or changing?
Changes.
Changes, sir. So after summer, winter, winter, summer, it will be keep changing, yeah? Or is it fixed? It's so after Monday, Tuesday only will come. After Monday, I'm telling. If you say yes or no, then I will come to know. Yes, guys? Am I clear with this example, what I told? The fixed things are called as time variant. So I gave example, months in a year, the seasons, or days in a month, or days in a week. Is it changing or is it kept constant? Have you understood the logic or not? So my voice is delaying for you. Are you not able to listen what I'm telling? Or any delay is there with my voice here to everyone? I'm audible. Am I audible? Is it audible, yes, guys? Sir. Yeah, you got what I asked? Did you got the concept of time variant and invariant examples? What I told? So where the time is fixed, there is no change. That is called time variant. Where there is a slight change with respect to my time, that is called as time invariant. Is this two examples of what we discussed with respect to these two topics? Is it okay to everyone? Is it okay? Yes or no? I'm audible, Ananya.
Yes, sir, there was some disturbance, sir.
Okay, fine. Now is it okay? My voice is clear?
Yes, sir.
So have you people got the examples what I told for time variant, invariant, or you want me to repeat once more? Anybody wants me to repeat the example what I gave for time variant invariant, or is it okay? Yeah. Is it okay with that concept, Ananya?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So then we'll stop the session today. It's already time. So we'll continue the properties in the next class. So try to glance at the thing what I